One day, I'll have to get a real job, but I don't know what I'm going to do. I've been brainstorming possible ideas of what I can do. I was thinking maybe I could open a daycare center. Seems like a pretty easy cash grab. Right? Like, what do you need to run a daycare center? A door that locks. It's going to be called Myles Anderson's Daycare. They'll be here when you get back. Obviously, I've tried teaching piano lessons. That was very difficult. Very hard to teach, musical things to younger kids, high musical concepts. I remember one kid I was teaching, and I was like, "Oh, you gotta play here on the page. You gotta play this because that's where the beat is." And he was like, "What's the beat?" And I was like, "It's the beat. The beat is the it's the." You gotta know. I can't show you what the... Get out of my daycare center. I wish I was just born like a rich guy. I wish I was just born a rich guy so I didn't have to do anything. But at the same time, like, it messes people up to just have a bunch of money for no reason. It definitely screws with your brain. And it's weird when you see... rich people being interviewed on TV, and they're just like, "Oh, we're just like everybody else. We just don't worry about money anymore." And I'm just like, that's a huge part of our day. And they're always insane. They got the one kid who got arrested a few years ago for like crashing his McLaren into like a drugstore and killing people, and he claimed he had affluenza, which was like a condition brought on by having too much money. And I'm like, well, that's like a real thing. If you look at history and you see like these weird rich emperors and stuff, like they're completely insane. Like I remember I saw this documentary on the Roman Emperor Caligula, and he was a very famously rich and debaucherous man. And I saw this BBC documentary, and this woman's in front of like his big palace. And she was saying, "This is Caligula's palace. It was behind me here that he had many hedonistic activities, including in his pool, he would train a team of young men to swim between his legs and nibble his genitals. And he called them his little fishes." And I was like, my God, the money this man had to train people. They had to gather there in the morning, like, "All right, little fishes. We're going to start the training. When you go down there to nibble his balls, you're going to think, like, how's the most obvious way to do it? You're going to turn upside down. Dumb move, amateur. You're going to get water up your nose. You gotta plug your nose, do one pass maximum, get a bit of air and go back down. That's how the pros do it. If you do a good job, he will have sex with you. And if you do a bad job, he'll have sex with you. He's Caligula. I know you may be intimidated that he's the emperor and he's a super powerful rich guy, but I assure you, he's just like everybody else. He just doesn't worry about money anymore. Just like us. I